Hello guys and welcome back to another vlog. You're probably thinking, I'm in New York, skyrise apartments, high buildings, New York school buses. No, I'm actually in Bradford, yes. We've imported this bus all the way from New York, 3,000 miles away. It's landed here on a shipping container and it's come here to Bradford. Why? I've been given another big challenge to convert this New York school bus into a mobile library. So that's exactly what we're gonna be doing. And it's a bit of a big challenge, but it's for a great cause. I've been given this big challenge by National Literacy Trust. They want me to convert this bus into a mobile school library. We'll be going around different communities in Bradford and promoting reading and literacy. Now, look at the state on the bus. Well, first of all, it's all faded in color. We need to convert it inside as a library. And we've got Dean going around with Imran, who's head of this project, and we'll be talking to him very shortly and seeing what needs doing to this bus. Bit of a challenge, but it's for a great cause. As you can see, this is a standard New York school bus. It's got all the gadgets in here, all in its original form. Now, I don't want to press anything. I'll probably break anything, should I say. Hello, guys. Can you just stop messing around in the back, please, and just sit down? Thank you. Hey, man, what's up, dude? Ah, good, man. Whoa. Right, I'm really bad with my American accent, okay? But I have lived in America for about 8 months when I was 16 years old. I went after my GCSEs and I lived out there with my cousins. I've got a lot of family in Chicago and Arizona. So a big shout out to them if they're watching. Love you all and hopefully see you guys very soon. And I love America. I've traveled a lot of America and it's an amazing place. And I will be going back very shortly actually. But anyway, it's all about this New York school bus. First time I actually ever sat in one and they are quite big and mammoth. So this drive around in Bradford will be a real head turner. This is what it's all about. We need to convert this bus. So, well, it don't really need to turn heads because this bus will turn heads in itself. The key thing is to get as many kids on here and promote reading and literacy and obviously let them develop in life because it's really important to study, guys. And that's what we try to promote in Bradford. So we're driving around all communities and hopefully there'll be times where I'll be on the bus as well, giving a little bit of motivation to the kids as well and to promote reading. So if anybody does want to get involved with this project, please do contact us. So let's go out, speak to the project manager, Imran and Nabila, and let's see exactly what they want to do to the bus and see if I'm up for the challenge. Imran, how's it going, mate?
All right, Nav, how's it going?
Should I say my, hey, man, what's up, man? Should I say my New York accent?
You say whatever.
Nabila, how you doing? Are you okay? Project managers of Bradford Stories. Right, Imran, do you tell us a little bit about the project and what it's all about and what we want to achieve from this?
The bus project is a part of the National Literacy Trust project that we have in Bradford called Bradford Stories, and it's a campaign really to give opportunities for young people to get involved in literacy and reading.
Okay.
But not only literacy and reading, also we're talking about things like building their confidence, to give them the ability to write, all the things that set them up for later on in life.
Yeah.
So this bus is it's come over from the States. It was something that sort of Nabila pulled out of her hat.
Very iconic. Yeah. I mean, we normally see this in the movies, but now, you know, we're looking to see this in Bradford. Question is, how long have we got?
Well, we're a fan of your vlogs now, so we know that you can turn stuff around pretty quickly, so you've got...
But most of that's edited though. So give me a realistic date.
We've got next Friday, any good for you?
So you've got what, 6 days? Well, okay, let's have a look. Let's see what we need to do on the bus first anyway.
Yeah.
Start from the front.
Yeah.
As you can see over here, the bonnet is faded really badly. Now, New York in summer gets really hot.
Pretty
so much. All that needs painting.
Yeah.
Okay, some cracks I've noticed over here.
Yeah.
The brackets for the mirrors. And then you've got the grill that's all flaking off. The bumper is in a bit of a bad condition as well. For all these bolts on these wheels, the wheels itself need refurbing. The whole bus doesn't really need painting, does it? I think most of it we can probably polish. They bring it back to life, the colour's faded, but it's more the bonnet. And so anyway, the back bumper as well, so we need to do all the back bumper and we're going to put, you know where the decals are going, don't you?
Just
so we'll go more into detail during the vlog of what we're going to be doing. So Nabila, what is it, what when you get a bus? Why not first bus? Why a New York bus?
I like things to be different. I remember having a conversation about an art bus in Edinburgh and thinking that we need a bus in Bradford. But I also know that we can't just have anything average in Bradford. So I ended up searching buses from America and finding this guy who sold these buses and brings them over on a big vehicle carrier and then converts them out. So I contacted him and he happened to have a bus available for us.
It's a great opportunity for young kids in Bradford. And it's definitely going to, I mean, wherever you drive this, I mean, it's obviously going to just turn heads in itself, isn't it?
And yeah, that was the idea, that it's sort of, you know, it's obvious, it's in your face, and people can get excited about it when we have an event on there.
Yeah.
And we rock up in a local area, in a community, in a park.
Yeah.
And we can get loads of the community together to come on board, to get the books, to have conversations. We want you on the bus as well, and have come.
I'd love to be on it. I mean, of course,
inspiring the next generation.
Yeah, that's what it's all about. But what's so important about reading?
Literacy is an issue that it's linked with poverty. So you know where you've got areas of deprivation,
yeah,
right? And say that you're a parent who's not had a good experience at school. You might be jobless, then you can't pass that on to your children to support them. So
yeah,
home is really important. And having good literacy skills, and that sort of, it's reading, it's writing, it's speaking, it's the ability to, you know, communicate confidently.
Yeah, yeah.
It set you up for later on in life.
Yeah, of course.
So setting them boundaries, or setting that foundation.
Great foundation, yeah. Great foundation.
That's what it's all about. It's about giving kids the opportunity.
Well, I'll probably test my reading later on as well. I don't read as much, but I should do. And there's never an age to stop reading, is there? So what kind of books are you going to have on here? Any specific authors, or is it just...
Anything and everything, really. So we one of the things that we really try and focus on is, like, who are the authors and the stories that are going to, like, interest the kids. Mm-hmm. So a book that's been written by somebody whose name sounds similar to you, who's got a similar story to you, who talks about something you're interested in. Simple example, you know, football.
Yeah.
Some of the boys, they love the football.
Yeah, books, yeah.
Right? So there'll be loads of those. And then it's also about, like, just a real mixture of different
local authors.
Yeah,
we really want to play tribute to local authors and really put Bradford on the map with the bus. And I think that's one of the things we want to do, is really celebrate Bradford.
A new challenge on my head, something very different. So let's get it, well, part of it in the workshop, because we'd have to strip most of it in the workshop. And this will not go into my workshop with the size of this. So we'd have to utilize the council depot. Thanks to them as well for letting us use their facilities. So we're going to strip this bus down, paint what we need to paint, and Dean's going to wrap what he needs to wrap, and we're going to get it ready to make it into a mobile library. So let's crack on with this challenge. I put this on my Instagram that I'm going to be taking on this mammoth task of customizing this bus into a school library. Derek seen it on Instagram and he went and spread the news to everybody in the garage. And before I even got back to the workshop, everybody knew. And he was the culprit. You were like, are we really taking on this mammoth task? You said that, didn't you, Derek?
Yeah.
Did you get scared when you seen that big bus? You did, didn't you? You thought, oh my God. I've painted some big things in my life, but I'm not painting that bus. Right, so we've taken it on. The bonnet's off. Lads have done a good job taking the bonnet off, but as I predicted, I thought we would snap the bolts off because they were very rusty, and that's exactly what happened. So the lads have been drilling some new holes for the bonnet brackets and getting all that sorted out, because what happens is all the bolts are rusted. So when you try opening them, they just snap. And that's the biggest headache when it comes to rusty cars or buses or any form of vehicles or anything, actually. So all the bonnet's been buzzed down. Derek's buzzed all the bonnet down, getting rid of all the reactions. He's filled it over here. And you can see there was that big crack where the big mirror was. I can't even call it a mirror. It's huge, isn't it? And we've taken the trims off. Grill, where's the grills?
Here.
The grills are here. So they were silver, but I think we should change the colour of these.
Yeah.
What colour do you think we should go for?
Let's go for black.
Good answer. Black. I thought you might have said pink. It's your favourite colour, right?
No, not mine.
No? I like pink. I think I can rock a pink t-shirt and a pink shirt. Let's do a competition. Why not? Since it's a good cause, I'm feeling happy, I'm feeling positive, and obviously, hopefully you guys will take use of this bus once it's all done. So the competition. Okay, let me think of a good question. Something quite simple, or maybe something that you can easily research. Right, okay, I've got the question in my head. So when Prophet Muhammad was in his cave praying and meditating, Angel Gabriel, or Jibrail in Arabic, came to him. And what was the first thing that he said to Prophet Muhammad? Just comment with the right answer, and I'll pick one random lucky winner on next week's vlog. The winner will get a lot of educational books. So yeah, good luck guys, and just comment below with the right answer. And for now, I'm gonna crack on and get this bus finished. Okay, so we're in the council workshop. We've got the bus parked up over here, so thank you to the council for letting us use their workshop. So this is the Bradford Council workshop where they maintain and repair all their council vehicles. And as you can see, they've got all their trucks, lorries, dustbin vans, any vehicle that has to do with the council is repaired and maintained over here. So it's raining outside as well, so luckily we've got a spot where we've booked it in to get this bus all done. Got the bonnet on the way, Asad and Luke are just finishing it off in the workshop. And I've got the boys prepping the wheels because we're going to paint the wheels, paint the bumpers. We've got Dean who's going to wrap all the bus as well, and we're going to buff and touch it all up where we need to get it all done. We've only got till today to get it complete because on Friday we're doing the launch. So let's just go around and see what we're up to, where we are. Dean, what's going on? Do you need a hand? What's going on, Dean? Who's that?
That's you.
No way. Yep. Look at that. That's actually a good imitation of me, mate.
Put Nav in there, look.
Oh, that's sweet. Dynamite or Dynamo?
Dynamo, innit?
Dynamite.
Dynamo, that's the one.
Oh, listen, that's look at that. Multicultural, Bradford is full of culture. So, and we've got Imran over here. Hello, Imran, what are you carrying? Imran, what are you carrying?
What's some books, man?
Are you going to test us?
Sorry?
Are you going to test our reading?
Oh, yeah.
Right, listen, these books are too thick for me, mate. I always put these on the side.
There's nice picture books as well.
Oh, I like picture books.
See, so you could have a whole conversation around, you know, what's going on in those pictures over there.
How many hours or minutes should you read a day?
Yeah, little and often. So, you know,
10 minutes?
10 minutes a day.
10 minutes
yeah,
a day?
Literally 10 minutes a day, yeah. Parents might complain that, oh, my 10-year-old boy, right, he's not interested in reading, he's dropped off. That's quite common.
Yeah.
And I think the trick to that is sort of finding different things. There's different things that you can read that grab your interest.
So find something that you're interested in. On that note, we've got the bonnet that's arrived. Keep coming. Look at that, we had to get a recovery out just to bring the bonnet back. I mean, we did bring it on a recovery truck anyway. But as you can see, the size of the bonnet is huge. Kindly, as you know, you've seen Zafar, aka Pa, who's kindly used his recovery truck to bring the bonnet over here. Pa, thank you very much. Did Luke get here safely, yeah?
Yeah,
yeah.
In one piece.
Would he hold on to dear life when he was driving here? Yeah. With the wheels all over, Luke? Oil levels, everything, and you know what's wrong with it anyway, so just let's get that fixed, get it started up. And anyway, what's going on the launch?
So the bus launches this Friday, so we've got a launch in City Park where we've got school groups coming along. We're doing like a ribbon cutting, lots of authors that are going to be running sessions on the bus throughout the day where school groups will be coming and they'll be having like interactive storytelling or poetry sessions on the bus.
Oh, nice.
We'll be gifting loads of books, so thousands of like free books for anybody that comes along on the day. And after Friday, Saturday, Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday, it goes on a community tour around Bradford, different parks, different venues. All the events are free, you don't need to sign up, it's there in your community, come along when it's there. Have a look on the website, bradfordstories.org.uk, that's got the timetable on there.
Okay.
It tells you where we're going to be. We'll be doing lots of events in schools as well as communities and trying to get the word out. So look out for it in your localities, in your local area. All the events on there are going to be for free.
So we're giving books away free on this bus, so take note, guys. And on that note, while the guys are finishing off the book, while the guys are finishing off the bus, I'm going to grab a book and start reading. got book, yeah?
Alright.
Right, okay.
Yeah,
you done that, yeah?
Yeah.
Right, okay. You're not going to buff the bus now.
Okay.
Luke's going to buff it. Okay, he's just got a little bit more experience. Okay, so watch him do that. And then the parts that he can't buff, you're going to do it by hand.
Yeah.
This is a bit different for us. Yeah, but we're helping the community, we're helping the youngsters, even adults, to promote reading. How good are you at reading?
Very good.
Yeah? Okay, wait there, let me test with you.
Okay.
Right, okay then. Start from here then.
Okay. So even though Aisha was only 12 years old and chained up, Ringo felt a great disadvantage. He made for the door, spluttering, "I will be back. I'll return with one of my more unpleasant associates, and then we will see if a few doses of a very horrible pain
help to
loosen your clever tongue." Aisha did her best not to look frightened.
It's like you're doing it to school kids. You win that challenge. I'm not even going to challenge you on that one. Well done, mate. I'm really impressed. Anyone looking out for an apprentice teacher?
Oh, yeah.
Got G over here. Ready. Yeah, you can take him part-time. I don't mind. Anyway, crack on. Okay. Let's get the bus buffed. You can see the difference over here already. That's with the colour being faded after buffing it up. Look how how the colour's popping. So buffing makes a big difference. So inside the bus now. We have to get it all complete, so we're just finishing off inside of the bus, as you can see. All the cushions. Where are all the cushions?
The cushions are in the back.
Right. So Nabila's just loading up all the shelves with all the books. So these are the books that we're giving away. Let me just give you an example over here. We've got a book over here. So it's quite a very high quality book. The Family Tree by Suresh Hussain. Apparently this author is from Bradford. So yeah, kids, so make sure you get on the bus when it comes around your neighbourhood, because there's some fantastic books on here. Ready?
Come on.
Get in there! She's starting! Oh, wow. Finally, the bus is all complete. It's 10 a.m. Friday morning and the bus is parked in Bradford Centenary Square. We finally managed to get it all complete. It started up and it's looking gorgeous. We've got a load of school kids come today as well for the launch. So we're going to be cutting the ribbon and we've got a couple of councillors here, and we've also got the chief executive of the National Literacy Trust who's here today as well. And we've got Imran and Nabila, really excited. Got all the kids from different schools. And we're just going to be cutting the ribbon right now and giving away free books and letting the kids know and teaching the kids and educating them on how important it is to read. And you can see all the smiles on the kids' faces. And we'll probably go on the bus now and show you the final finished result. Here you have it, guys, the Bradford Story Bus. Library bus.
Good.
You like it?
Yeah.
Right, okay, so have you all got your books?
Yeah.
Well, right, mine is not book, it's a Wonder Journal.
What do you pick? Let's see the book that you picked.
I want the Harry Potter one.
You want the Harry Potter one?
Yes.
The Harry Potter one was over here. I remember seeing it yesterday. I'm sure, I think they might have run out, but I'm going to get you a Harry Potter one. You know, reading is very important. How much time do you spend reading, or do you spend more time reading or on computers? Now, don't lie.
On computers. I can still read
one. What's your favourite car?
Lambo.
Lambo?
My Ferrari.
Ferrari.
Bugatti.
Now, listen, make sure. You guys want them kind of cars?
Are we driving?
McLaren. Okay. Right. If you want them kind of cars, you got to work hard, you got to develop and make sure you read at school and at home. You can be a school bus driver, you can be anything you want. You put your mind to it.
I
want
to be an engineer.
And I want to be an engineer, I want to be a scientist.
You can be anything you want to be, but it's important to read. Okay, guys? So we're all going to promise we're going to read at least half an hour every day, or at least even 10 minutes.
I'll do 100 books.
Oh, well done. Go on.
I'll
get you the Harry Potter book. So make sure you tell your friends to get on the bus and get themselves a free book and make sure they read the book as well. Got all the kids with their goodie bags full of books as well. So let's go speak to Imran and the chief executive, Jonathan.
Hello.
Jonathan.
How are you? You okay?
Nice to meet you, sir.
Good to meet you.
What do you think of the finished result?
It could be more impressive. I mean, this will excite kids across Bradford around reading. It's the specification is so high, it feels like the best for the kids who deserve it the most.
Yeah,
so,
I mean,
thank you.
Imran and Nabila. Come here, Nabila. Why are you hiding for?
I got you a biscuit.
I got you a biscuit.
There you go, the school.
Oh, look at that. So I just need the vinyl wrap on there now, don't we?
Yeah.
I'll customise the biscuit for you as well.
Customise the biscuit.
Now, the serious thought, Nabila and Imran have obviously been working tirelessly. When they brought this project to me first, I was like, are you guys serious?
Yeah, I kind of had the same reaction. I mean, you know, if that's not your first reaction, then it's not an exciting project, is it?
Yeah, I was in two minds when they told me about it, especially when I saw it in person as well. I was like, it was a rough bucket, need all restoring, but then I thought, it's a great cause. I mean, the kids, I mean, obviously they love it. And I think we should have one in every city.
I think we should
set an example here, Nabila.
Absolutely. Nabila can have a fleet of buses across the country.
There you go.
I'm up for the challenge. Ask me next year.
Right, so happy day. So where are we going to be stopping the bus anyway? Do you want to let everybody know where we're going
to
be?
Sure, yeah. So after the launch today in City Park, tomorrow Saturday we're going to Morrison Victoria, we're going to West Park. We've got Attock Park, there's a whole programme. So if you go on our website, bradfordstories.org.uk, you'll be able to see where the bus stops. And it's all local parks. It's going to Whipsea, Girlington, really sort of all around Bradford. So look out for it in a park or a community centre near you.
Yeah, definitely. And hopefully some of them days I'll be on the bus myself, motivating kids, inspiring them as well.
Fantastic.
And working the team. West Park in Girlington, and this is the park that I actually grew up in. I remember when I was a toddler, just like some of these kids over here, I used to play around. I used to play football, cricket, on the swings and slides. I've got a lot of history in this neighbourhood, and I've always wanted to give something back to my community. And this is a great thing that we're giving back to the kids and the youth of today. Hopefully they can take advantage of this. People could follow from this example, obviously educate our kids, motivate them in the best possible way. And I'm going to... Oh, hello, kid.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Good.
There's something I need to show you.
You need to show me something.
I need to show you something as well.
Come on then, show me. Let's go.
Let's go, guys.
Come on then.
Look at this. Enkahnz partnership with
Enkahnz. Oh, what's this?
Enkahnz.
Oh, wow.
And something else.
Something else.
Who's this?
Who's that?
Nanny McPhee.
Yeah, Nanny
McPhee. Who's that? Let's have a look.
That's you. And then it has an Enkahnz.
Does it look like me?
Yeah. With the long beard of yours.
Oh, you know who did that? This young lady behind you. Noreen did. You know, tell her how good it is.
It looks very good.
Thank you.
Noreen, how are you doing?
You're
doing a beautiful job of this illustration.
Thank you.
You know all the designs on the side as well.
Yeah.
And how long did you take?
It was like 20 hours or something.
Whoa.
It took a long time to get everything right because you can do all the base and everything and then like there's changes that you need to make and there's bits you need to add on.
Right, Deanna. So, you do you like drawing?
Why do you ask that? I absolutely love drawing.
Oh. Do you want Noreen to teach you how to draw as well? Because she's a very good artist, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, where's all your work? Where can Liana see all your work then?
All my work's on Instagram. It's Noreen Artie.
Noreen Artie. Well, this is Noreen's Instagram link. So if you do want to have a look, you can go check it out.
Hi, my name is Boris J.
My name is Adam Khan.
Hola, me llamo Fatima.
Hello, my name is Rayan.
My name is Liana.
Hi, my name is Rahan and I'm from Girlington, Bradford.
I like the bus, it's very colourful.
I think the bus is really great for kids.
I picked out some books and if I read these books, it'll help me to find what I want to be when I'm older.
When I'm older, I want to become a software engineer. And
in order for me to become a businessman, I need to read.
I want to read so I can become a doctor when I grow up.
And I want to be a doctor and a lawyer when I grow up. So that means I need to read a lot and learn a lot in school.
When I grow up, I want to be a chartered accountant. But in order to do that, I need to study, I need to read, and then I need to get especially a math degree.
They're giving out free books and I picked them up and they were free.
So Ryan's going to read for us, everybody.
Oh.
Yeah, so let's all give... So Ryan's going to sit over there and he's going to read.
I guess Mum was pretty proud of herself for making me write in that journal last year because now she went and bought me another one.
Well done, Ryan. That's good reading. Well, round of applause to Ryan. 7-year-old Ryan. Ryan, it's really important that you continue reading that book because you know why it's important to read.
Because if you grow up and get something, if you've got like a contract to read...
Oh, you're looking for big contracts when you grow up, yeah?
Or counting money and stuff like that.
Well, reading's very important because you know what? It helps you develop your brain as well.
And okay? You get smarter whilst reading.
It gets you what, sorry?
Smarter.
You get smarter. But do you like the bus, guys?
Yeah!
Do you think we're doing a good job of it?
Yeah!
Do you think it's a good idea? So are we all going to read books?
Yeah!
Okay, so that means we've done a good job, right?
Yeah!
Okay, come on then, let's get off the bus. Anyway guys, thank you for coming and thank you guys for watching. So that's our Bradford school bus built. And it's been a success, Imran. What do you think so far? Good job.
Unbelievable now. Absolutely.
You've done a great job, yeah?
Yeah, after the amount of sort of like the everything where everybody went through when lockdown happened, they were at home and we couldn't get out to people. In the last 4 days, we've reached thousands and thousands of kids all over Bradford, in all the neighbourhoods in Bradford. And every single time this has come out, everybody it's turned heads on the road, which is what we wanted it to do. And it's really, really sort of inspired and enthused kids to get stuck in.
It's all right, we're just filming. You could just come in and sit over here. Sit on my lap. Right, carry on talking. It's Isa, by the way, Imran's son. How are you doing, sir?
Isa, you all right?
Isa, how important is it to read?
Very important.
You do read a lot, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah? So what's your favourite book?
I like the Harry Potter books and the Alex Rider ones, but right now I'm reading the Narnia ones.
Narnia ones?
Awesome.
And do you know how important it is to read? I mean, what's the importance of reading? Why? What does it do for you?
It increases your vocabulary and makes you better at writing and talking. And
there you go,
trains
mate.
Your eyes as well.
Yeah, good. And it develops your brain.
Yeah.
What do you think of the bus?
It's nice.
Yeah? Looks good? Yeah. It stand out?
Yeah.
Did you spot it from your bedroom window?
Not from there, but as soon as I was coming up, it was the first thing
you
I saw.
You can't miss it, can you?
It's been a success. And obviously thank you to Imran and obviously Nabila for all the inspiration. Nabila, you might have come on while you're over here anyway. Come on, why not? The brain's behind everything. The mastermind.
The vision.
We executed it well, teamwork.
Yeah, it was complete teamwork, man. Completely.
Hopefully we can see a lot more in Bradford and around all the neighbourhoods and the cities of England, should I say.
Yeah.
It's a great idea. Are you going to copyright this, trademark it, or what? Or is it,
no,
is it...
I want this to be duplicated everywhere. If we can get this in every city and inspire more and more children, that would be an absolute dream. We've got it here, we want it everywhere, so yeah.
So this week has been a success?
It's been an amazing success. Like, you've seen the crowds today. That has been every single day we've had those crowds. We've had so many children take books home. We've had so many children smiling, reading with parents. It's been an incredible experience. It's been heartwarming. I've loved it.
Well, if we can change one person's life from this, or many people's, hopefully, that's a job well done. And we need to continue helping our communities, all the youth, invest in them, not let them spend too much time on. I know it's a digital era, and a lot of the kids, you know, spend a lot of time on YouTube and you know, things like that. But I think it's very important to read as well. Even if you read maybe 15 minutes or 30 minutes a day, you know, it'll help you. Like Isa said, you know, how it helps you develop. So let's all inspire all the kids of today and continue this journey. And we'll see you on the next vlog.
Next one.